Good evening and welcome to the 2016 Glendale College Athletic Hall of Fame Dinner. Throughout the years, for those of you who have been here before, there are some wonderful stories and fantastic accomplishments. Tonight, these inductees rank right up there with one of the greatest classes. We introduced them earlier. So first of all, a round of applause for all the inductees that are coming in tonight. My name is Spiro Saltis. I'm proud to be the MC. My job is to move the program along, introduce the inductees. So without further ado, as dinner is being served, or if you haven't quite got it yet, we're gonna stop for a moment, and please, we ask you to stand, rise, stand at attention, with your right hand over your heart, and address yourself to Old Glory behind me, as we honor the great nation that we are in, those that protect us, those that have given the ultimate sacrifice for our freedom. We are very pleased to have Cecile Santiago. Please join in the playing of Francis Scott Key's The Star-Spangled Banner. This is the national anthem of the United States of America.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight o'er the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming.
National anthem. Thank you. As you sit down and get ready for dinner, before they step away, you've been enjoying the musical stylings of the Glendale Community College Jazz Combo. Please, a round of applause for the music. They're going to be back a little later. We wanted to introduce them before they step away. Thank you. Dinner is going to be served, or is being served, and then we will continue with the program. We have a wonderful program coming up. The combination of Glendale College, the community, individuals that have landed support. It's a wonderful program. Sit back and enjoy. We'll be starting very shortly. Thank you.
I am David Vire, and I proudly serve Glendale Community College as its superintendent president. And I want to welcome all of you, distinguished honorees, your family and friends, our GCC alums and community supporters of this region's great educational asset, Glendale Community College, a college with faculty and staff working every day to achieve our vision to be the greater Los Angeles region's premier learning community, where all students achieve their informed educational goals. Tonight, we recognize very special athletes, accomplishments, and winning. But tonight also is about recognizing the value of intercollegiate athletics and the role athletics plays in developing life success qualities of leadership, teamwork, cooperation, sacrifice, confidence, discipline, responsibility, good health, and character. Your attendance here tonight shows that you agree, and we thank you very much for your support of Glendale Community College Athletics and Glendale Community College as a whole. So the tailgate party is over, the national anthem was sung, you're in your seats eating, which is fitting for any good sporting event. And as with any good Vaquero athletic team, we're going to start strong and open with a big score, presenting the Glendale Community College Distinguished Community Partner Award. The award criteria are leadership and commitment to advocating for the educational needs of our community, collaborative work with organizations so as to enable them to significantly enhance their programs and services to the community, and philanthropic leadership through the business in which one works. There are business leaders who are winners related to the bottom line of their businesses. There are business leaders who seek to succeed at any cost. There are business leaders who push for success on the backs of their employees. And then there are business leaders who exhibit the very qualities I described earlier that we hope become part of our student athletes' lives: teamwork, responsibility, character, discipline, and service with and for others. In 1976, Oliver Shoku left a good job as a project engineer at Ford in Detroit, Michigan, to chase a dream in California. The opportunity was not only to be a business owner, but to shepherd the name Harley-Davidson into what was then our small town, Glendale. The venerable motorcycle brand not only became a staple in Glendale, but throughout Southern California, as Oliver Shoku's business savvy, his passion for motorcycles, and what came to be a philanthropic vision made him one of the most successful Harley-Davidson owners in the country. In 1984, Oliver established the Love Ride as a vehicle for motorcycles to support various charities, and for over 30 years, it annually attracted over 20,000 riders and raised significant levels of money that was returned to our community and its worthy causes. Along the way, a chance friendship with then Superintendent President John Davitt brought the Shoku vision of philanthropy to Glendale College. And decades later, as you walk our campus, you see Shoku's levels of support have been far-reaching for our college. Walk around the campus and you'll see banners, room plaques, and salutes to the Love Ride and its contributions back to Glendale Community College and its students, including, when you're down on the athletic field, the press box at Sartorius Field, which carries the name of its sponsor, Harley-Davidson. Several years ago, Harley-Davidson was the grand sponsor of our foundation golf tournament and has been a playing sponsor for decades. Gail Davitt, Dr. John Davitt's widow, says, "Oliver contributed a tremendous amount of resources to Glendale College and never said no whenever John asked. Their friendship was beneficial for both of them. John got a chance to express himself as a motorcycle rider." And yes, you should see the pictures of him on his motorcycle with his leather jacket. "And Oliver was exposed to philanthropy in ways that were far-reaching in support of the college and nationally because of the Love Ride. In being honored with the 2016 Distinguished Partnership Award, we salute Oliver Shoku and Glendale Harley-Davidson for not only having made significant contributions to Glendale Community College, but defining for others what a community partner is all about. Please welcome Oliver Shoku."
Well, thank you all for coming tonight and supporting this great event. I'm really proud to be considered for this honor and to be among this very distinguished group of past honorees. I started my business back in 1976 as Harley Davidson of Glendale, and during the past decades, I've decided to give back in some way back to the community that I love, the city of Glendale, and it's been a big central part of my life. I'm very proud of it. It's great to have been in this great community. The Love Ride was a significant event that I organized. During its 32 years, we raised some $25 million, of which, after expenses, actually $16 million in checks were written to various charities. Because of the friendship that I had with the late, great John Davitt, I want to call him, he not only helped me administer this event, but helped me to strategize in many ways that only a college president could do, and helped Love Ride Foundation in great ways. And he advocated children's charities, whether for health or for education. And that was pretty much the theme of the years and years of the Love Ride. And luckily, Glendale Community College was also one of the beneficiaries of the years of the Love Ride. So it's great to be here. I want to thank you all for coming out here. Great friends, my two daughters are sitting over there, and they were also a big part of the Love Ride in many years. And I'm honored. Thank you. God bless you all.
Okay, on behalf of the Planning Committee and Glendale Community College, we certainly hope that you've enjoyed your dinner. Everything has progressed nicely. A perfect example of Glendale Community College, education for the future, alliance with the community, and the city of Glendale and the surrounding areas, and that's a perfect example for Oliver. Thank you very much. Congratulations. As we move on with the program, we want to take just a moment to introduce a few dignitaries. We have representatives from the Glendale College Board of Trustees. We'd like them to take a wave, and again, so important in the college and all of its activities. The president, Mrs. Anita Quiñones-Gabrielian. And just give a wave to wherever you are. Vice President, Dr. Armine Hakopian. Board members, Dr. Vahe Perumian. Glendale College student trustee, Mr. Emin Azarian. The current president of the Glendale College Foundation Board, Mrs. Pat Crouch. And our distinct pleasure to introduce the new superintendent of the Glendale Unified School District, Mr. Winfred Roberson. In the back. Welcome. And now, ladies and gentlemen, please help me welcome the event chair for this great program, a Hall of Famer to everybody, the past athletic director, current Glendale College Foundation board member, Mr. Jim Sartoris.
Welcome, everyone. As a chairperson of the Athletic Hall of Fame Committee, I want to take this opportunity to welcome you to this year's induction ceremony. It's our 15th annual event, and for me personally, and I know for a lot of people here, it's really the highlight of the year for me. We speak of Glendale College family often, and it's never more on display at a Hall of Fame event. I would be remiss unless I mentioned great college and community leaders like Walt Smith, Bill Gallagher, John Davitt, who were part of the creation of this event in 2002, but who have passed on. They would be so delighted that we continued to honor the great achievements of men and women athletes, coaches, and contributors to Glendale College athletics. With our long and great athletic tradition, it's not hard to find people that qualify to be in this Hall of Fame. The difficult part is finding four or five each year that we want to honor. We have a committee that works hard to vet all the possible candidates. It's a difficult task, but they work very hard all year long selecting these inductees each year. The event tonight is the genesis of the Glendale College Foundation. We used to meet up in the Hall of Fame room up there with a smaller group and with the leadership of Lisa Brooks and our presidents of our presidents of our foundation. They felt this was a great opportunity not only to honor our honorees, but to use this as a way to help support financially our athletic department. I'd like to recognize a couple of individuals. Certainly, this person needs no introduction because she is so involved with everything associated with our Glendale College Foundation. She does a great job throughout the entire community, not only for Glendale College, but I'd like to introduce Pat Crouch, our president of our foundation. Pat, stand up. And I'd like to also obviously acknowledge our director of the foundation, Lisa Brooks, who does a tremendous job. The efforts of the foundation really come directly back to students, student-athletes, and all students in their work. So I appreciate everything that you do. Finally, I'd like to recognize a number of the members of the Hall of Fame that are here with us tonight. These are past inductees that return just about every year, and I'd like them to just quickly stand and so we can recognize them. From 2006 class, Mike Haney, tremendous athlete in golf. 2007, meritorious achievement, Ted Tiffany. Ted, where are you? There's Ted, former trustee at Glendale College for many years. Class of 2008, Tom McMurray, a great coach, great track coach and athlete here. Class of 2010, Bill and Ethel Gallagher. Ethel, please stand. Great contributors to our athletic program over there. Great contributor in class of 2012, Chet Williams. Chet, where are you? Stand up. Also in the hall right now, in class of 2013, great, tremendous athlete, Bill Stokes. Bill, where are you? Stand up. There's Bill Stokes, USC. A tremendous coach that we recognize in the class of 2013, our women's athletic director, tennis coach, Terry Koblenz. Terry. We recognize in the class of 2014, a great contributor and a really active person in all our committees here on the foundation, Harry Hull. Harry, where are you? Stand up. There's Harry. Outstanding coach in the class of 2014, still our athletic director, John Sakuto. Johnny, there we go. Last year we inducted our longtime basketball coach, Brian Boschman. Brian, right there. Also last year, a tremendous soccer athlete and football, Victor Trujillo. Victor, where are you? Also with us from last year, a great contributor, a longtime counselor that did tremendous work with our student athletes for years and years and years, class of 2015, Joe Puglia. Joe. I'd like to introduce one more person. I'm going to call him up. The class of 2011. Tremendous athlete here at Glendale College, Chris Hale. Chris was an All-American defensive back for Glendale in 1986. The Vaqueros were ranked number one by J.C. Gridwire for most of the 1986 season with a 10-0 record. The GCC defense allowed only 113 points during the season and shut out four conference opponents 189-0. He was a two-time CIF Southern Section long jump champion at Monrovia High School in 83 and 84 and was recruited to run track at the University of Nebraska out of high school. Hale played in championship games in high school, at Glendale College, at USC, and in the NFL. He played in two Rose Bowl games at USC in 87 and 88. He also played in three Super Bowls with the NFL Buffalo Bills in 91 through 93. He has been the color analyst for Fox Sport West Prep Zone television broadcast for the past several years. He has recently been hired by the NFL as a uniform inspector for the Los Angeles Rams, whatever that is, and is president of the NFL Alumni Incorporated Southern California chapter. He was inducted into our GCC Athletic Hall of Fame in 2011 for outstanding athletic achievement. I want to call Chris up here right now. I want you to give him a great hand. He's going to talk to you about maybe some possibilities of helping us support financially our athletic department. Chris, come on up.
You that much taller than me? Pull the microphone down a little bit. When Alex Leon and Mike Haney asked me to talk about my life at Glendale and how I could help fundraise for the university, the first thing I thought is I'd never done this before. So I'm here to help the fundraising efforts of GCC Athletics. And I'll start off, Alex, I'm going to turn the script around a little bit. They had also asked me to talk a little bit about myself and what my road was that helped me at Glendale College compared to what it would be for anybody else. So I'll start with the facts before I get to my story. Of course, my story was we were in the broom closet when we did our induction to the Hall of Fame in 2011. So I'm glad to see it's grown so much in the past few years. So here we go. The athletic department depends on the foundation along with athletic coaches to raise money to help 16 teams. Can you believe that the total amount of our Glendale athletics receive $90,000 a year? That's $5,625 per team to cover transportation, equipment, uniforms, etc. for the entire year. This also includes providing our athletic staff the supplies for over 300 student athletes per year. Compare that to $14.7 million a year for a four-year university on average. The Glendale CC Associate Student Body helps out greatly by providing funds for officials, entry fees, meal money, and away trips, but the funds available from the college is woefully inadequate. When you consider the cost of each of the helmets at $250 a piece, a baseball bat at $200, a pole vault pole at $500, you can imagine the burden and the pressure put on the coaches for every team to fundraise for GCC Athletics. Our goal this year is to double the amount of last year. It will make an enormous impact on your young athletes' ability to compete and to succeed. And while I'm talking about that, I believe there's a table full of athletes here, or two tables full of athletes here. Can you guys please stand up for me so people out here can recognize exactly who you are? You should be commended on your efforts. It takes a lot to be an athlete at any level. Now I'm going to talk a little bit about what got me here and what got me to Glendale. And so everybody always tells me to tell my story. And for those who weren't here in 2011, what do I got, Alex? I got 40 minutes, 50 minutes? I got, no? Cut longer? All right. For me, what makes Glendale so special is I have an unusual road that I had to take to get to Glendale College and to the to college football and to the NFL. And as you see me, you obviously know that I am not large in stature. I am not like Brett Miller, 6'5", 290-pound stud. When I came out of high school, I was about 5'6", 5'7", about 145 pounds. And at that point in my life, I thought that I was good enough to play anywhere. And so I was a track athlete slash football player, at least I thought I was. So the first thing I did was I took a half scholarship because I just thought I needed an opportunity to the University of Nebraska as Coach Red. And so when I went to University of Nebraska, and back then it was the Big Eight, I competed in track and field. And halfway through the football season, they had just won the national championship the year before that with Turner Gill and Mike Rozier, who won the Heisman Trophy. And so when I got there, I would sit alone in the stands and watch them practice on the football field. And I told myself, these guys can't compete with me. And that was my first thought. And so I walked on to the football team at Nebraska. And so obviously Nebraska has at least 150 athletes on the football team. And so I looked at the depth chart and I was fourth on the depth chart. So I had a lot of guys to go through and most of them were all All-Americans. And so we played a game, fourth on the depth chart, and we played against a smaller Alabama squad. And they had a receiver that had an enormous game against us in the first half. And they went through all three of the All-American defensive backs that they had on the field. And so they got to the point where they said, Chris, get in the game. It's almost like a movie, right? Chris, get in the game. We need you. I get into the game, make an interception, save the game for the team. We beat them 30-28. Before that, I had to test. Like everybody knows the combine for football. So you have to test. You have to run the 40, do the broad jump, do the whole thing. I broke Nebraska school record in the vertical leap. And so by the end of the football year, I led this team in interceptions. I still didn't start, but I led the team in interceptions. So at the end of the year, I went to Coach Tom Osborne, who was one of the biggest coaches in college football history. And I said, Coach, I want to stay here. I want to play football at the University of Nebraska. I think it's meant to be. Coach Osborne said to me, I don't have any more scholarships left. I don't know what you're going to do. I said, I'll work. I'll get a job, I'll do anything it takes to stay here and play. So he said, our players don't play. We practice in the summertime. And he said, and I had a $100 phone bill. I couldn't pay the $100. He said, what are you gonna do? I said, I'm leaving. So I came back home and I said, I got a chip on my shoulder. I said, nobody in the world gives me any props. Probably because of my size. They just don't want to give me anything. So I said, I'm quitting sports altogether. So I came to Glendale College. I enrolled, and Coach Cudo had me in meetings. And I fell asleep in meetings. Is that true, Coach? Felt right. What the heck are you doing? You know how he is. Fell asleep in meetings. I got up and I said, Coach, I don't love it anymore. I don't feel like playing. I'm going home. I went home. Didn't play for the whole year. Finally, I came back that next year. And I said, Coach, I want to play again. Coach said, I'm going to be honest with you, Chris. We got two guys in front of you. One's going to San Diego State and one's going to Texas A&M. I said to Coach, play him. Right, Coach? Play him. I'll find my way. The one thing about Coach, the one thing about this system, Coach Sartoris, Coach Cicuto, is that they care for every single player. Every single student that walks through this door, they put their heart and soul in it. They're not like coaches, because I've had a lot of coaches in my life. Their soul goes into your soul. They feel what you feel. They want the best for you. 3 or 4 weeks in the season, right, coach? Those two are switching off, and I'm starting, and all of a sudden I'm an All-American again. And yeah, it worked itself out. And all of a sudden, we're getting calls from everywhere across the country, right? USC, Arizona State, Georgia, whoever. I picked USC, obviously, fight on. And, you know, pretty much the rest is history. And I've got to say, what catapulted me into who I was as a boy, into a man, was attending Glendale College. There's certain things that a coach lines you up on to put you in the right situation, not just to succeed in life, but to give you life experiences and to teach you how to handle things going into the future. So for that, I say thank you, coach. Thank you, Glendale College in general. And I'm going to give all the credit. I would not be where I was now without Glendale College. With that being said, it's pledge time. I try to pull at your heartstrings a little bit to get you to. So the first thing is, for those who want to give, there are envelopes on your table that you could secretly give, or that you could put up and give to the people around who are going to be at your tables. Turn around and you'll see them in the back. And you can, and I'm gonna do a live auction first. So the first thing I'm gonna do is I'm gonna jump off the stage and go right into the audience and see who wants to bid. And the first place we're gonna start is at, what are we starting at? 100,000? Alex, what are we starting at? Oh, five. That's close. Here we go. Thank you.
Again, we want to thank Chris for coming up and doing all that. Thank you, Chris. And again, those that donated to tonight, thank you very, very much. But keep in mind, if you wish to do something for the college privately, please get a hold of the college and you'll be duly recognized in the way that you would want to. Thank you very much. Well, after all that, it's time that we give congratulations and acknowledgments to the inductees of this year's Hall of Fame. Our first inductee for outstanding team, the 1979 men's soccer team. And as we read the accolades, please notice the boards with the wonderful stories and pictures that go on, because it's the stories that over the years you truly need to hear, and not of the most notable that you may have heard of, but just stories from within Glendale College and their stories. And also part of that team, obviously a very big part of the team, was Coach Sharif Zinn. All over the world, has coached everywhere and back. Tonight, it's about his time at Glendale College. Former men's head coach considers his greatest success guiding the Vaqueros to the 1979 state championship. He won the title again in 1983, and the team was inducted into the Hall of Fame in 2005. But he considers this 1979 team his closest group and his greatest triumph. Victor Trujillo, All-American of the 79 team and an inductee in the Hall of Fame already, has very fond memories of that team. coached by Coach Sharif, was a phenomenal group of athletes that could have beaten many Division I teams, and he is proud to say so. An extremely close group brought together by a great coach and achieved many great things that he is extremely proud of to this day. And I'm sure that would go for every member of that team. Zane also cited the development at that time of the multicultural atmosphere here at Glendale College, and that his players created on campus as a memory that stays with them to this day. Activities like the Pele and International Cup energized the whole campus, and students from many different countries cheered on the teams and created a bond for Glendale College students and his players that exists to this day. With great pleasure, being inducted into the Hall of Fame for Outstanding Team, we'd like to bring up the members of the team that are here today and the award presented to the Outstanding Team, this 1979 men's soccer team, Coach Sharif Zain. Please come up. Coach would like to introduce the players. We have Coach Sartoris presenting the plaque that's been designed for each group going in.
It's amazing. I haven't seen some of these guys for 35 years. Bobby Parra right here just flew in from Buenos Aires, Argentina. Raise your hand just for the induction. Jaime Aguirre from El Salvador. Cesar Hidalgo also from El Salvador. My All-American Ariel Mayorga, Colombian also. Both Colombians were All-Americans here. Next is Lázaro Enríquez from Glendale High School, one of my players from Glendale High. Next to him is León Bueno from Mexico. Next, Milton Hidalgo, I stole him from the football team.
Yeah.
He was a kicker on the football team. He had never played soccer. Ironically, he became a pro soccer player and played at San Diego State and never played soccer till he came to Glendale College. Amazing athlete on the football. Milton Hidalgo. He is now the coach at San Diego City College, and I beat him twice at Pasadena College, so he's very upset. And in 83 also, I beat him at Glendale College. So I just know all the tricks, and now he's trying to learn. Next to him, from Spain and from Greece originally, Vasily Pargurtis.
Yasu.
From Senegal, mon grand ami Lucien Niang went on to play at Point Loma. And it was good because I spoke all the languages with these guys. I speak French, I speak Arabic, I speak Farsi, I speak anything. And now I have to learn Armenian in Glendale because now it's becoming an Armenian city. So I'm learning. I eat Armenian food every day. It's catching on. My All-American and personal friend, and I coach his kids also, Victor Trujillo, Sheriff Victor Trujillo. And one of the reasons for the success was my assistant coach and partner, Michael Muscari, is also school teacher for the LA Unified. I want to thank Bill Reinhardt, very special. I've coached 41 years in Southern California, 41 years of high school head coaching. I've coached at Cal State San Bernardino, Pasadena City College, men and women. But my time at Glendale College was the best. My father is buried here in Forest Lawn. After I graduated from UCLA, I came to take care of my mom in Glendale, and someone knocked on my door and told me that I know that you played at UCLA. Can you help me coach Glendale High School in 1975? And that's how I started to coach. And I fell in love with Glendale. I love Walter Smith, and I love Dean Davitt. He used to call me all the time to the office. He goes, you know, I am the dean of soccer. So he loved me a lot, and I had a lot of great conversations with him. And I came here, and I just remembered all these great memories. And I saw all my former coaches that here, Narum Bochman and Murray, and it's amazing. This was one of my best places ever. I want to thank everybody for nominating this team to the Hall of Fame, and congratulations, and thank you very much.
Coach Sartoris is presenting the plaque to the coach, but representing all members of that great team. And again, a league championship is very special, a conference championship. These were the state of California champions. Congratulations. I see that it was mentioned that it was the emergence of a multicultural sensation. If you heard where they all came from, I just call it darn good recruiting myself. I don't know. That was worldwide, and they all came to Glendale. Just wonderful. And it's wonderful that as many members were able to make it today as they did. Our next category, in the category of outstanding athletic achievement, congratulations to Tony Hoggetts. In the 15 years we've had here, there is a common thread, and most of them will say that during their time at Glendale College was that fork in the road that Glendale College put them on the right path. Tony came to Glendale in 1997 with a reputation as a dynamic player, but not one to stay in one place for very long. 4 years of high school, he attended five different schools. He cited various reasons for bouncing from one high school to another, but said that he found a home when he committed to play at Glendale College. He credits head coach, Hall of Famer, Brian Boschman, and his coaching staff, as well as his teammates, for teaching him the game of basketball at GCC. He led the team to consecutive state Elite Eight appearances, named California State Co-Player of the Year, averaging over 16 points, over 4 rebounds, almost 6 assists, and almost 2 steals per game, while leading the team in scoring, assists, free throw shooting, and scored in double figures 29 of the 34 games. Western State Conference Most Valuable Player as a sophomore, All-Western State Conference, and All-State as a freshman for the Vaqueros 1997 and 98. And now has returned to Glendale College to the Hall of Fame for outstanding athletic achievement. Tony Hoggetts.
Wow, this is a beautiful thing to see everybody here. I'm glad you showed up today. Thank you for showing up. I know you see the paper, but don't worry. It won't be that long. You know, first of all, I just want to say, you know, thank God for everyone showing up here safely and getting here safely, you know, and being able to show up in an event like this. Again, like I said, it's a very welcoming and a beautiful experience to be a part of the GCC family and just the support that you guys give. Like you say, just growing up in high school and bouncing around from school to school and not finding a place. I remember the first time I actually stepped foot here at Glendale College, and I met this guy, Brian Boschman. I just didn't even know what I was getting myself into. I saw the fire in his eye, and I saw the commitment that he had on and off the court with his players, and I never experienced that support before. And I knew at that moment, I said, this is something special here, but it was kind of scary. But as I continued to stay with it, it was the biggest and the most best commitment I ever made in my life, because he actually changed my life on and off the court. So I just want to say thank you, Coach, for that, first of all. And big time to me. Just the 2 years that I played here, I was blessed to be around a team of players that are great staff, you know what I'm saying, of coaches. William Hubble and Bruce Ikey and Alex Devontian, we were a complement of Kevin Kreider. We had a staff of coaches that were like uncles and fathers and brothers that it was just impossible to not want to come to practice every day. The support system that they gave you made you feel like you can accomplish things that you didn't even feel like you could yourself. And I mean, the recruitment that they had, they just surrounded us with the players of like Denny Ogden, who could shoot the ball with the gym lights out. And then we had Jake Willis, who can create. He was our white chocolate. And you know, we had other players on our team that's just, I mean, when you walked in the gym, you knew this is something special. These guys might win some games this year. And just to be a part of that, I mean, it was the best team I ever played on my life. And not just because of the winning tradition, but just the support of brotherhood that we had. I mean, we had any culture that you wanted to name, we had it on the team. But when you walked in, you only seen one name on the jersey, and that was Glendale. And we represented it very well. And it's Whenever we stepped in the gym, anywhere on the road or at home, it was the type of cockiness that we carried together from that locker room downstairs up to the floor. You knew it was some excitement about to happen. And again, like I said, from playing in the university level, from playing overseas and just playing basketball as a total, I've not encountered that yet, even though it's over, you know, for me. But I've not encountered that in my whole athletic career, and it's just something that you would never exchange for in a day of life. And I've just been blessed again with just, you know, surrounding players, you know, like I said, and to support, because again, as me receiving this award is a blessing, and it's like a, something that I would never imagine, never expected to even achieve the Hall of Fame, but I am very grateful. Is this, I never would have received anything like this without the support staff of the type of team, the type of you know, foundation that Glendale gives you. And I've heard a couple of people say tonight that just being a part of a Glendale foundation as it is, it teaches you how to be a man. It teaches you how to grow up. It teaches you how to appreciate things, and just knowing that you have a family to come back to every year. And I'm most appreciative of that. And pretty much that's it. Again, I'm very grateful to be here, very grateful to be a part of something that's very special, and go Vax.
Congratulations, Tony. Hall of Fame plaque. For just a brief moment, we want to introduce, and those that are members of the Glendale Foundation board members, along with Pat Crouch, can all the board members that are here please stand for all your devoted work, members of the GCC Foundation board. Pat in the back. Rick Dinger. Thank you very much, and for all you do. In the category of meritorious service, it's a great pleasure to introduce into the Hall of Fame Frank Farwell. Frank Farwell is quick to think back fondly of the years that shaped his life as a football player here at Glendale, 82-83, assistant coach from 94 till 2009. All those home games for the Vaqueros were actually short road trips down to Glendale High, where so many memories playing and coaching for Glendale are still vivid. Also quick to remind everybody that there is nothing more important to Frank than family. His own, the people he works with as he manages them at Southern California Edison, and the ones that have come and gone in over a 30-year relationship right here at Glendale College. He considers himself dedicated to all three, tireless in his love and devotion as a family man, employee manager, and former football player, coach, and supporter for the Vaqueros. In the matter of Glendale College, Farwell has not coached since 2009, but has continued to support all sports here through his own donations that are matched by Southern California Edison, which he's done since 1994. The first year he came back to coach with the defensive backs. He smiles when he asks why he still gives back and still continues to give, but it's obvious his commitment to helping support GCC athletics is as strong as it ever was. He says he gives back because of what Glendale College has meant to his family. His wife Tammy was a cheerleader. His sons Tori and Tanner were ball boys. Tanner was a player and coach. He says, I still give back because I know the financial support helps all sports in a much needed way. I'm still in shock about going into the Athletic Hall of Fame. I've seen so many ceremonies and watched so many people being honored that I still can't see myself standing up there in this way. But I'm very humbled and honored. He definitely deserves to be with that group, and tonight he joins them. A round of applause for the category of Meritorious Service Award, Frank Farwell.
I'm kind of going to kick off where Chris Chris left off. When you came to Glendale College, you know, you had Coach John Secuto and Coach Jim Sartoris. They took a personal interest in you as a person. They developed you academically, socially, and then athletically. Their philosophy was, you know, it helped them, us and everyone that fell behind us win during their tenure. Life is about the positive influence that people have on your lives. Coach Sartoris and Coach Secuto had a huge impact on not only my life, but many. They taught us to have integrity, respect, excellence, continuous improvement, and teamwork. They taught us how to fight through adversity and take responsibility. They also taught us the difference between a successful person and others is not a lack of strength, not a lack of knowledge, but rather a lack of will. I can never thank them enough for the guidance and leadership that they've provided me and others in this program. I would like to thank Tammy. Unfortunately, she passed away in July. She loved Glendale College. She was a cheerleader here. She loved coming and seeing all the games. And normally, Chet reminded me of this. Normally, when you'd walk in a Sartoris field, you'd see her sitting in the stands, and you see that big smile on her face, ready to cheer for the Vacs. She also loved going to Stengel Field, watching Chris Secuto's teams compete, and then being at these games on Friday, watching Brian Boschman's teams compete, especially when Tony Hogatz was playing. This school's been a big part of our life. Our son, Tori, graduated here. Our daughter, Sarah, went to school here, and then Tanner played and coached here. I can never thank Glendale enough for all of the things that they've done for my family and the wonderful memories that they provided. I'd like to give Coach Secuto a special thanks. Fortunately, we've been blessed to be able to donate back to this athletic program. And Coach does a wonderful job distributing that money to where it's needed. I'd like to thank everyone that showed up tonight. And a big thanks to Glendale and also Coach Jim Sartoris and Coach John Secuto. Thank you.
The next category, Outstanding Athletic Achievement. And we welcome Brett Miller to the Hall of Fame. This is a personal pleasure for me too, because I've had the pleasure of being a friend growing up with Brett from the time I was 8 years old. We played on the same T-ball team together. And you start adding up the years, and it was a long time ago. But it's wonderful to have him here tonight, and my pleasure to help induct him. Back in the summer of 76, though, he was the tallest pedicab driver in Hawaii. It must have been quite a sight, 6'7", 200 pounds. Brett was just another happy-go-lucky 18-year-old out of high school, graduated from Glendale High, and was giving rides to tourists, surfing away in between work in Hawaii. Fast forward 40 years, Miller's life journey took him from Glendale High on to Glendale College, the University of Iowa, and finally playing professional football for 10 years in the National Football League as an offensive lineman for the Atlanta Falcons, New York Jets, and San Diego Chargers. He told us in the interview that it was probably the best choice, though, he ever made was starting right back up here at Glendale College and playing for Jim Sartoris, John Secuto, because they were mentors, and he still considers them people he looks up to today. Devoting 10 years in the trenches of the National Football League, life of organized chaos. Relatively healthy after battling all those years, though, trying to mess around with 300-pound defensive linemen, blitzing linebackers, quick and strong defensive backs. Watch out for those guys coming up like Chris Hale from the back, sneaking in. And looking to harm the quarterback that he was protecting. He had put on the muscle mass after high school, and at one time during the NFL was voted the strongest man in the National Football League. After his career, he worked in front of the camera as a sports reporter for Channel 5, TV shows and film, and now working in real estate and spending time with family, daughter, and grandson. And tonight, he comes back to Glendale to enter the Hall of Fame in the category of Outstanding Athletic Achievement, Brett K. Miller.
Hey, guys. I think that was actually 123 games. It's not 118. But, you know, who's counting? Well, I got to tell you, there's a common thread running through this whole thing, and it has to do with the guys that run this program. So I'm going to give you my path to Glendale College. It was certainly a little bit different, but seems to kind of be the way that things go here. I could have been thinking about a lot of things to say about this program that expressed my gratitude and the difference it made in my life, as well as the joy it brought me. And the lessons I learned while I was lucky enough to be part of the Vaquero tradition. As some of you might know, I took a little bit different path arriving here at Glendale College. I was not the all-star high school football player that most of the guys that come here were. But nonetheless, the coaches reached out to me at Little Glendale High and offered me an opportunity to play some football. I half-heartedly accepted. But then with no warning, I decided that my time would be better spent moving to Hawaii. I was 17 years old, a bit naive, strong-willed, and like most 17-year-olds, I thought I had all the answers. Well, my parents, God bless them, supported me in everything that I ever did. And the move to Hawaii was really no different. They helped me pack up all my stuff. My pop hopped on the plane with me so that he could help me sign a lease. I was only 17, and I just knew that Hawaii was my new home. Well, after a few days at working at Dole Pineapple Plant, about 8 months of driving a pedicab, I'd had enough. So it's time for that phone call. Mom, Pop, I want to come back home. You were right. Without hesitation, they helped me get back to California and out of pineapple tourist hell. But now what? Oh, I know. I'll get a job at Ralph's grocery store. Pop was a district manager there, so I'm in. Perfect, right? So 6 months later, I'm working as a retail clerk at Ralph's in La Cañada. Making pretty good dough. Bought a new Trans Am. Living at home. Money in my pocket. Life's good, right? Again, the coaches came knocking. Again, I said, sure, I'm in. How about if I play a little tight end? They were like, sure, whatever you want to do. So after winter workouts and some spring ball, I pulled another disappearing act. It wasn't for me, like I said earlier. I was not the typical football guy. Not really that high on my list of priorities. So after another 6 months at Ralph's, I began to realize that I did not want to be a retail clerk for the rest of my life. Nothing wrong with that. Just wasn't for me. But how could I change that? My parents would do anything for me, but how could they justify and how could I ask that they send me to college when I'd flaked 2 years in a row? Can't blame them. So after some serious, serious self-evaluation, as much serious an evaluation as you can do when you're 18, I decided to swallow my pride and go talk to the coaches here at Glendale Junior College. Before heading to talk to Coach Satoris, I ran into a guy named Greg Pierman. We sat down and chatted for about 20 minutes. He shared some of his stories with me. as well as told me that I had a real shot at a Division I football scholarship. Now, I don't know if Greg could read my mind, but I was like, yeah, right. A Division I scholarship? Whatever, coach. But what Coach Pyramid did was plant the seed, the maybe seed. And after my chat with Greg, I went to the football offices with my hat in my hand to speak with Coach Satoris and Coach Sakuto. Now, these two guys didn't owe me the time of day. After all, I'd stiffed them 2 years in a row. Not only did they give me the time of day, they embraced me. They welcomed me to the program. The only requirement from them was that I give them everything that I had to give. And they promised to give me the same back. Well, Coach Pyramid may have planted that seed, but Jim and John and the rest of the football staff watered that seed. And that seed began to grow. They showed me how to set goals, how to be disciplined. And my teammates taught me how to really play the game. I'd always known how to compete. I'd always had a fire inside. But they taught me how to refine it, how to focus it. And they showed me what the great game of football is really about. It's about brotherhood. It's about loyalty, commitment, integrity, accountability, leadership by action, overcoming adversity and the odds, being tough, enjoying the fight, relishing it. But most importantly, it's about having fun and pushing all your chips in and letting the cards fall where they may. That's what this program and the coaches do for young men that are lucky enough to be part of the Vaquero tradition. Everyone here, from top to bottom, cares about the young men here. They water them, and they help them grow. That's special. And the people are special, and they make us all feel special. Now, this place may have the best locker room in junior college football. And I don't even know how to describe the training room. But they have the best people in all of junior college football, hands down. So I would like to thank them all. Jim Satoris, John Sakuto, Gary Spubiller, Greg Witsit, Greg Pierman, Mike Scarpace, Dale Logie, Hank Paz, and of course, Joe Puglia, the academic magician. So many things come to mind when I think of my time here, the players and lifelong friends, Greg Tillman, David Tillman, Paul Petratus, Jeff Wrongley, who, by the way, redefined the kicker position. Jerome Potter, Michael Odom, Gordy Bohannon, Keith Chappelle, the list goes on. I was lucky enough to make a living playing the game that I love for a little while, and it all started right here. And it started because of Glendale Junior College people. I could stand up here and tell you stories all night. Maybe I could tell you some of them. But none stand out so vividly in my mind as the ones I carry with me always from this exceptional program that is spearheaded by exceptional men. Finally, I'd like to acknowledge my mom and my pop, who I miss every day. They were the real deal and always showed up for me with unconditional support and love and always believed in me. I owe them everything. And also the two most important people in my life, Haley and Gianna, my daughters. From the minute they came into this world, they have inspired me. They showed me what real love is. I am so proud of the stellar people they have both become. The world is a better place with them in it. Anyone who has the opportunity to be a part of the Glendale College program, athletic tradition, should consider themselves very fortunate. For me, to be invited into the Vaquero Hall of Fame is humbling, and without a doubt, one of my proudest achievements. I would like to thank you all from my bottom of my heart. Go Vax, and thank you all again.
Wonderful, Brett. Wonderful, Brett. Thank you. And of course, he mentioned that historic locker room and training room in beautiful words. But again, that's why your support, and when we come here all the time, is going to help change that someday. It really will. But again, he also mentioned Jose, Claudia, and the entire training staff, too, that it can never be thanked enough for all they do. In all sports, for both teams, home and away, visitors, anybody. Just going to take a quick time out here, and we want to give special thanks to the Hall of Fame Planning Committee members that make this bigger and better every year, now in their 15th year. Could the Planning Committee members that are here please stand up and be recognized where you are? I know Alex hides in the back. Mike, Pat. This night starts months ago with a lot of planning and a template that's fantastic, and this is what we see tonight. Thank you very much. Our next category, Outstanding Coach. Congratulations, Diane Spangler. It would only seem fitting that after two of her teams, three of her athletes were inducted into the Hall of Fame, Diane Spangler would get her shining moment as a member of this Hall of Fame as coach in 2016. 40 years ago, 1976, she gets a call from former Glendale College Hall of Fame inductee, Virginia Manker, about a coaching opportunity here. And over the next 15 years until 1991, she coaches women's cross country, track, volleyball with great success and spent 35 years at the college teaching physical education and health. A tremendous athlete at Glendale High, Glendale College, and as an amateur athlete before she started coaching volleyball over at Hoover High School. She stood proudly as Donna Mayhew, 2002, the 1977 women's cross country team, 2003, Julie Flynn, 2004, the 1978 women's volleyball team in 2009, and Angela Collins in 2011. All inducted into the Hall of Fame, and all have said that without question, they would not have received their honor without the guidance and dedication of Diane Spangler. Making no effort to contain her excitement about this honor tonight, she's thrown herself into the process just how she would have competed as an athlete and led as a coach. Left no stone unturned in making sure that everybody that mattered in her life is able to attend this ceremony tonight, preparing for the occasion just like a coach prepares for a game. Before we bring her up, all of the friends, supporters, and colleagues and family that came, would they please rise on her behalf? Many tables and a lot of love. And as they stand, we now welcome tonight into the Hall of Fame in the category of Outstanding Coach, Diane Spangler.
One at a time there. Beautiful, darling.
This is a fantastic evening. This is a fantastic event that the college started 15 years ago. I'm so proud to be here this evening, I can't tell you. And with all my friends and family here, it's just amazing. I want to thank Glendale College and all my colleagues that I worked with here. I want to thank the foundation, especially Lisa and Ellen and Alex, you're fantastic. It was a pleasure to work with all of them in preparation for tonight. I want to thank the Athletic Hall of Fame Committee for nominating me and selecting me. I'm deeply honored and humbled by this recognition and honor. I want to thank my family, especially my brother Chet, who is here tonight. And I want to thank all my special guests. I have some people here. I have a lot of people, friends and family here tonight. And I wish I could say something about each and every one of them, but I've selected some that I want to recognize tonight. They all played a role in my life, and now I call them my friends. Leslie Obuck, my fourth grade teacher and coach for Dougal Willens Elementary School, BA, MA degrees, USC, physical education. Patty Mack, one of my high school teachers at Glendale High School in physical education, BA degree, physical education, Occidental College, MA, Cal State Los Angeles. Both of these women were tremendous pioneers in Title IX, which was passed, the legislation that was passed in 1972 by President Nixon, which changed women's sport and athletics forever. Julie Flynn, La Cañada High School Basketball League champion, 1973. Glendale College Women's Track and Field State champion, shot put, 1979. Hall of Fame inductee, 2004. Lori Carter, Hoover High School Girls Volleyball League champion, 1975. Glendale College Women's Volleyball Conference champion, 1976. PhD, Computer Science, UCSD. Professor, Point Loma, Nazarene University, San Diego. Judy Brubaker, Glendale College Women's Volleyball Conference champion, 1978. Hall of Fame inductee, 2009. Dual BA degrees, psychology, UCLA, physical therapy, Cal State Northridge. Marcy Connolly, women's cross country, undefeated state champion, 1977. Hall of Fame inductee, 2003. BS degree, economics, Pepperdine University, Malibu. Donna Mayhew, women's track and field team member, conference and Southern California champion, javelin, 1979-1980. State champion, 1980. University of Arizona Hall of Fame inductee, 1989. Two-time Olympian, javelin. 1988, Seoul, Korea. 1992, Barcelona, Spain. Pan American Games, Havana, Cuba. 1991. World Championships, Tokyo, Japan. 1991. Glendale College Athletic Hall of Fame inductee, 2002. Angela Collins, Glendale College Women's Volleyball. Setter, first team, 1983. Division II Women's Volleyball National Champion, Cal State Northridge, 1987. Honda Broderick Award winner, Outstanding Women's Collegiate Athlete, 1987. Reebok Player of the Year, 1988. California Collegiate Athletic Association MVP, 1987. Cal State Northridge Hall of Fame inductee, 1993. Glendale College Athletic Hall of Fame inductee, 2011. California Collegiate Athletic Association Hall of Fame inductee, 2016. BA degree, kinesiology, physical education, Cal State Northridge. Yvette Irons, women's track and field team member, conference champion, 1980-1981. Women's cross country team member, undefeated, conference champion, 1980. BS degree, exercise science, Cal State Northridge. Corey Yeager, BA degree, English, College of William and Mary. Credential, English, George Mason University. Adjunct instructor, credit ESL, Glendale College, Citrus College. Ellie Bloomfield, MD, UC Irvine School of Medicine, BS degree, physical therapy, Loma Linda University. BA degree, English creative writing, Stanford University. Janine Scheinhorn, MD, ophthalmologist, Louisiana State University Eye Center, Tulane University School of Medicine. It's all about people, helping people, inspiring people, impacting people. And you know what? It's just like a game. But there's two mandatory requirements. Number one, we've got to always remember that we must play by the rules. Number two, game on.
signature clap. Okay. Coach Torres. That's beautiful. Thank you, Diane. Congratulations. Thank you, Diane. In the category of Pillar of Achievement, Robert Dos Remedios. It's mentioned that the toolbox for Robert is quite full these days. Great demand as a speaker and provides demonstrations all over the world to share his expertise in strength and conditioning. Looking back on his days at Glendale College, where he played football and then coached, Robert said, "I grew up as a player and a young man at Glendale College. Strength and conditioning coach at College of the Canyons starting in 1998 until last year. The first full-time strength and conditioning coach hired in the state at a community college. Helped over 200 athletes get scholarships. And has worked with football players who played in the NFL and helped College of the Canyons win over 50 conference titles and the 2004 football championship, that's national championship. Also named the National Collegiate Strength and Conditioning Professional of the Year, 2006. And tonight, back to Glendale College to take his rightful place in the Hall of Fame in the category of Pillar of Achievement. Please, Robert Dos Remedios.
How do I follow the Diane sparkles? How do I follow everybody? That was amazing tonight. Wow. So with my luck, I'm the second offensive lineman in one deal, and I got to follow Brett Miller. Look how handsome that guy is. Jesus. And I have giant paws, and I shook his hand, and it was like grabbing five bananas. All right. So just want to acknowledge, I'm going to go through a lot of stuff. We're going to get out of here. I got the phone call, Jimmy. Jimmy called me. He called me 2 days ago, and I was actually writing my speech. And he's like, "Dos, what's going on?" "Oh my God, Jimmy, what's going on?" He goes, are you excited?" I'm going, "Oh, I'm stoked. This is amazing. I write my speech right now." "Well, that's what I'm calling to talk to you about." You know, these things, people go on and on and on. Can you keep it to 5 minutes? So I was just like, terrible. So I have two tables of amazing people here with me, family, friends, coworkers, lifelong friends, interns, former athletes. This goes on and on. My mom is here. Mom, raise your hand. My mom and dad came to every game here, and it was like a huge deal. It was like, if anybody remembers, Billy Stokes is here, Bobby's here. There was a crazy guy with this bullhorn in the stands. They would go da-da-da-da, like that. Like, he would do that constantly. It was like really irritating, but that was my dad. So they became part of the family here. My father-in-law Joe is here. Where'd he go? Oh, there he is. He's filming. That's what he does. He took over as my dad. My dad passed away. My sister couldn't be here tonight. She's ill. But my brother-in-law Colm is here. Colm is the women's soccer coach. He's an athletic director at Occidental College. So he knows what's going on over here at Glendale. My wife Francine. My daughter Annabella. They are definitely the lights of my life here. Quick shout out. I had an amazing night last night. I drank some beers, but it wasn't because of the beers. Keith Noop, who is a former standout here and coach with me here as well, got inducted to the John Burroughs High School Hall of Fame last night. So could give you a little hand here. Amazing. What he's done over there, I have no idea how you've done it, my friend, but you've stuck it out for a long time there. Keith coached with me and I was the coach over there. So funny story, I kind of mentioned it to Brett when we were here earlier, when I finally got to meet him. When I came here to Glendale College, and everybody that's ever played here knows exactly what I'm talking about. Who played football here? Raise your hand. Right, you go in the office, and you look at that All-American wall, right? You know exactly what I'm talking about. Every day you walk in there, and you're like, they're looking at the wall. You're like, I'm going to get on that wall. So when I got here, I said, hey, coach, who's that last offensive lineman on that wall? And they point to this guy, and I go, okay, he's a local guy? Yeah, Glendale High School. He played pro football. This guy's the real deal. So I said, I'm getting on that wall, Brett. You were, like, that was my guy. So it's a pretty funny story, right? Because, like, now, here we are. We're both getting in. We got medals. I think they're kind of gold, maybe. And I ended up getting a picture next to his, maybe a few. I don't even, is the picture wall still up there? Yeah? All right, let's go look at it after. We're all going in afterwards. We'll grab some beers and go in there. Let's talk about Glendale. So Glendale is pretty amazing, right? I mean, it's tough to even think about what my life would be without Glendale College. So G-House, you know, we started doing that kind of stuff. And actually, when we were coaching, the kids started calling it G-House. But we have a saying here, right? You guys know what I'm talking about, right? Once a vac, always a vac. And I think Chris said it the best. How do you follow Chris Hale, the man who never ages? That gray hair, it's fake. He fake dyes gray in there to make it look like he actually ages. I think he sold some to the devil way, way long ago. This is kind of where I learned how to be a man, right? I learned how to, like, be responsible, and I learned that there was a whole other world outside of, like, living in Burbank. So when I came here, I got to meet these people, these new people. You get to meet people from the San Gabriel Valley and the Antelope Valley and all over the San Fernando Valley and the inner cities. We had Gila Ruta Flores here. So we had kids from Dorsey. We had kids from the inner cities, and the stories he'd tell you, I would just be like, what? There's no way it's happening, right? So to me, it was like this huge awakening in my life, and I wanted more. I just wanted to learn more about that stuff. I just wanted to, that got me into this huge thing where I just wanted to find out more about what's going on out there, because I felt sheltered at that point. So I got to meet a lot of friends, and then I also got to be part of the greatest team that's ever played here. No offense, Chris, who's here in 86, but 85 was on the inaugural team, Potato Bowl team, right? We got some guys here. And I always think about this, and I mentioned it to Bill Stokes on the way in here and Keith Noop. In 2004, we won a national championship at COC, and we had creatures. These are guys, right? Like four NFL guys on that team eventually, and they were monsters. You know, I helped create some of these monsters, but I started thinking, how would we match up against those guys if it was that 85 team against those guys? And obviously, I'm pretty biased, right? So I started thinking, there's nobody. We had no tackles that could block Bill Stokes off the edge. And I know we had no ends that could get around my edge, so I felt pretty good about that. I always tell people, if it wasn't for football, I don't think I would have gone to college. There was no drive there. I was always a good student, but it was never like, hey, I want to go to the college, I want to get a four-year degree. Like, I didn't really know what all those things meant. And I think a lot of us were in that same boat. We played athletics, and that's what we did. We had, some of us excelled more in school than others. But I think if it wasn't for football, I wouldn't have gone to college. If it wasn't for Glendale College, I wouldn't be where I am today. I wouldn't have been able to experience all these amazing things. And I do. I have a giant head, right? You guys keep seeing this. I keep seeing it on the screen in front of me. These pictures keep popping up. Let's talk about some coaches. Coach Scarpace. Coach Scarpace is a legend, right? And a lot of us know him. Brett was here with, I mean, he's gone through the gamut. He's produced so many amazing players. So he taught us everything. He was an USC standout, and he taught me how to play on the best position group in the world, the offensive line. And I know Keith said last night in his talk, you know, the defensive line, that was like it's like the center of the universe. I mean, I honestly think that there's really nothing like the offensive line, you know. It's like the big uglies, and we all kind of have the same kind of mindset. And a good friend of mine, Garrett 2J, who was our head football coach for many years at COC, said, you know, like, when you're growing up and you're a big guy, like for me, a big fat kid, like, what do? You go to the park and play catch? You go to the park and play block? Do I sit on a tree and just pass that on a tree? Like, it's a weird animal, you know? Nobody ever aspires to be that guy. So that's my life. Coach Sartoris, another legend. Can't say enough. Always played my heart out for this man simply because I never wanted to disappoint him. He taught me so much as a player, but when I came back and coached and had an opportunity to coach here in 1989 after graduating from Cal, he taught me a lot. He kind of calmed me down because I was nuts. So I'd get pissed off at everything, right? Everything. And he'd say, hey, Dose, you got to calm down, Dose. I'd say, this guy's a shit. He's not doing what he's supposed to do. And he'd say, that's your first problem. Your first problem is you expect everybody to be just like you, and it's not going to happen. So to me, it kind of evened my keel and got my mind right to coach for the next 25 years of my life. So can't say enough about that. Jimmy, another Hall of Famer. Coach Secudo, man. I mean, how many people have talked about him tonight? And every one of these things. I like to think that as a coach, I've had an impact on a lot of people. Are you kidding me? Like how many thousands and thousands of people? It's uncanny. Let me tell you about John. When I first met John Secudo, I was playing here. Used to practice at Glendale High School. You guys remember the Glendale High School days? Out there on the fields. And I would, you know, be going to meet Coach Scarpace, and I would hear this crazy dude screaming at this DBs, just on them in the distance, screaming. And I would be like, oh man. So, you know, we didn't really interact with them ever, right? And Coach was our defensive coordinator, and I used to say, so here's my strategy was, don't make eye contact with this guy. Don't make eye contact. And then maybe he'll never get on you like that, because that scares the hell out of me. And as I got to play here and got to meet him and know these guys, and they made the best part about my experience here was that, even at this level, interacting with the coaches on the other side of the ball all the time, just asking you what's going on, how's classes, how's your family, blah, blah, blah. Everybody knew everything about everybody here, and I think that's why you keep hearing these stories over and over here tonight. If you want to see the products of Jimmy and John, just look around the room. There's so many people in this room that played football here that have been influenced by those guys that are successful, amazing people. And I guarantee you that they got these amazing memories here. Main reason I ended up here at Glendale College, played football at Burbank High School, and I got injured my senior year. I only played half the games. So I played the first five games, got injured. I still got a scholarship to Cal State Northridge back when they still had football. It's 1984. So I was pretty stoked about it. My family's pretty stoked about it. School is going to get paid for and all that kind of good stuff. And I thought, you know, in my mind, that was my ceiling. I was meant to play there, you know, Division II football. That's what it was. So enter John Rome. Okay? Everybody knows John Rome in here. And John was a former coach at Burbank High School and Glendale College at the time. He was coaching at UCLA. And him and Steve Alamillo kind of tag-teamed me, and they called me. Well, John called me, and I get this phone call, and it's basically, what are you thinking? Why would you're not going? You're, this is how it went. You're not going to go to CSUN. You're going to go to Glendale. You're a Division I football player. You're going to Glendale. And if anybody in this room knows John Rome, knows exactly what I'm talking about. That's how exactly how the conversation went. Basically, I didn't. I don't think I said anything. And I don't even know if John knows this, but when I was a sophomore, they didn't have ninth grade football back in those days. We still had the junior high schools and the high schools. I almost quit my first year playing because I had this horrible coach, a coach that really turned me off to this game that's the most amazing game in the world, now in hindsight. But I almost quit this game, and John took me aside one day at Burbank. He was coaching varsity, and he said, just stick it out, and next year I'm going to be coaching you. And essentially, that's why I kept playing. I hated it. I didn't have any desire to play this game at all. So I'm sure glad that conversation happened. There's a saying about coaches. A great coach believes in you even when you don't believe in yourself. And I think all these coaches I've mentioned have had that play that role with me. This fat kid, you know, from Hong Kong, who had no idea whether the ball was pumped or stuffed. You know, it's amazing. That's why I always say to this day, my daughter plays volleyball, plays club, and all this kind of stuff, and everything's so specialized, and there's so much politics, and there's all these things. And I think football is still so pure, you know, where a fat kid that has clueless whether the ball is pumped or stuffed can actually play Division I football. So I thank everybody for that. So I've had a chance to accomplish a lot since that time, since my time here and coaching here. And at COC, we've had so much success. But there's not a single day, you know, that I don't reflect back to something. The successes I had all have something based on what I've learned here and the experiences I've had here and the bonds I've made here. And I think if all of us that have played here in any sport, coached here in any sport, can always think back to their times here at Glendale College and have a lot of positive memories. So this is surreal, man. I you know, that I'm even up here, it's amazing to be in this class of people and all the other classes that have come before us. So all I gotta say is, once a vac. All right, guys. Thank you, guys.
Really touching words, Robert.
Congratulations.
Thank you, Robert. Some great people, great accomplishments, and obviously a lot of sincerity and love. A round of applause for all the inductees that are now in the Hall of Fame. A really special class, no question. When we are done, we are going to ask, and we'll ask you in advance, please, inductees, please do not leave because we're going to have a formal picture. Please be seated. We're not quite done. Couple more things of business. It's a great pleasure at this time. We're going to bring up a couple of people. A friend of mine, an inductee from 2006, immediate past president of Glendale College Foundation, and a very dear friend in development and sports information, longtime friend here at Glendale, Alex Leon, a very special announcement.
Hey, what a great night. How about it? Two things I learned tonight. Brett Miller does have big hands. And Diane Spangler and Chet Spangler, I grew up with them, and we played street ball, where kids actually played in the streets and the golf courses and parks, and you always wanted Diane and Chet on your team. But what's exciting about the 15th year anniversary, we started a Hall of Fame club. And so for all the Hall of Famers here tonight, we're gonna have a little, you can check in over here. We're gonna have a part of being in the club. There's a sweatshirt, You'll get a lifetime pass to any Glendale College event, and then a pin, Hall of Fame pin. And all the Hall of Famers will be mailed the information. So we're starting a club this year, and I want to thank Alex and Lisa and the whole crew for everything that they do.
Hi, everybody. We really sit on tradition here at Glendale College. I'm a rookie at almost 20 years here at the college. If you're not 30 or 40 years or even longer, you don't have much time in. But I want to thank all of you. You've really perpetuated the growth of this event. If you go back to 2001 in our first meetings trying to figure out who we're going to be part of this group, is this event going to work? We've really come a long way. You should give yourself a round of applause because we would not be here if it wasn't for you and your support. Tradition means so much to us. The leadership of this event in terms of our supporters, as well as the MC. We have a tradition where we honor the MC after every 5 years. Joe Rico was our first MC. If Joe's name's not familiar to you, he played baseball here and then was our MC for 5 years. Harry Hull, who drew a tremendous job after that. And now tonight we honor the voice of Glendale College Athletics. If you ever come to a football game or a championship baseball team season, Spiro Saltis is the voice of Glendale College Athletics. He ends his 5 years with us tonight. I'm not saying he's done as the MC, but I'm saying that he gets his five-year plaque tonight for his yeoman's work, putting up with me, coming to many meetings, and tirelessly giving back to this program. Even though he is a Trojan, he keeps Glendale College close to his heart. So, Spiro, I'm going to give you your plaque.
You are going to get it. You are really going to. Oh, my gosh. Thank you very, very
much. Thank you very much. So next year, we will not have an Athletic Hall of Fame. This ends 15 years of consecutive Hall of Fames. Next year, we celebrate the 90th anniversary of the college. Very big deal, September 30th, 2017. I'm not quite sure where the event will be on campus. We're still in the development phase, but we'll be back in 2018 once again and hope you support the 90th anniversary of this great institution. Thank you.
Thank you, Alex. That was a huge surprise. The college continues to reach out. Sure, it provides information, provides you the opportunity to be a part of it, and we hope that you will reach out and give back. With the largest community college system in all of the United States, California does lead the way. And you have to figure, sure, they all have Hall of Fames, they all have great groups of people. I find it hard to believe there'd be a better group, more family-oriented, community-oriented, and that does something like this, anything better than Glendale College does, and it's a pleasure to be a part of this. Thank you very much. That just about concludes it. We'd like to have all members of the Hall of Fame come up for their formal picture. Thank you very much. Not next year, but we'll see you after that. Drive safely. Thank you. All the inductees, please come up to the front. All right, we want to make sure all six come on up. And then the opportunity to have pictures with coaches, supporters, friends. For the official picture, please.